Example in C++. And so we want to do fixed point filtering. So the input is 12 bits, and so that's essentially would fit into a short int. And then the coefficients we also would like to have at 12 bits, and that would be also a short, fits into a short int. So short int is 16 bits usually, and so let's say we would like to have number of tabs 1000. So that gives us roughly 10 bits. And so we're looking now at our formula here. I plus W plus log 2n. And so this I is 12. And then the scaling factor is 12. And then in the worst case scenario here, so the 10 would be 34 bits. The problem is that the normal, if you want to store it in an integer here and not using a long int, then 32 bits would be better. And so therefore, if we know that our impulse response, that's a gain, will be less than one, then we can omit this here, and then our 32 bits are sufficient for the accumulator, and we have also a bit of leeway there. Accumulator will be integer at 32 bits, but this is only allowed if we know what our impulse response does. But integer has this nice feature of temporary overflows, and in this way we can save and don't need to use a long int for that. And so now we just need to create our coefficients. Yeah, and so we do this just with the internal command of the we use the FIR win command to create our coefficients, and then so let's start in Python. So we're using Python for the design part here. So that's our design part, and then we do the actual filtering. Filtering in C++, and by importing the coefficients as a text file into it. Filtering in C++, and importing the coefficients. And As an example again, we do 50 hertz removal, what we have done before. Okay, so now let's generate the FIR coefficients. Let's generate the FIR coefficients, and remember, so we need to do this with the scaling up. So what we do is we use FIR win from of Python. Use FIR win of Python to generate the coefficients. To generate the coefficients, and then scale them up. So it's nothing dramatic with that. So I've prepared this here in this Python file. So in this case, I haven't used Spider, but just Notepad plus plus to do this here. So as a just in the usual way, I've imported the standard libraries here. And so what we see here, and then I'm setting the sampling rate to 1000. So what I want to have is just a standard barn stop behavior here. And so that we have a notch starting at 45 hertz and going up to 55, and our sampling rate FS is one kilohertz. And so now the crucial point is here this scaling factor here, so 2 to 12. So this just scales our function up here. So we see here, so first we are generating here our FIR filter with 99 tabs. Python doesn't like 1000 for some reason, so n is 999, and then we have our impulse response here, and we're scaling this up. Scaling by 2 to 12, and then what I do is in the last step here, so I just convert this here to integer, and then I just save it. And so I call this here coefficients 12-bit.dat. So now the rest is done in C++. And so what we do now is, so we import this here and do the rest of the processing in C++. And so let's have a look at the C++ implementation. And so here we have the code for this. So we have here first this. So we've got here these three files. Interested are we in the libfir1 here, and then in the fixed demo here. So libfir1 contains source files for filtering for FIR filters and the fixed precision FIR filters. So let's have a look at the fixed precision FIR filter here. And so we see here that the coefficient, we have a couple of constructors here reading the coefficients, and we define the number how is this scaled up, and then also number of tabs. And then here further down we have got our filter operation here, and we see so the input is a short int as an input here, and the output is again a short int as an output here. So the filter operation works on a short int and coming out. Yeah, so the C++ implementation so we have a constructor which reads the coefficients, and gets the scaling factor. As an argument. So in our case, 12-bit, and then we have a filter operation, filter method, and this. Emits a short integer, and then we have the filter operation, and again this gets its input as an short int. So simple as that. And so and therefore if you just go back here to the libfir, and then the whole thing is packaged this here into a library file, and then this can be used here by this fixed demo program here. So let's have a look at the fixed demo here. So the fixed demo does nothing else than reads an ECG which is 50 Hertz contaminated, and then it sends out an ECG which is filtered. And so we see here it's just a simple for loop. We loop through this here, and then the crucial command is this one here, where the value from the input here is filtered, and then generated an output here, and that's all basically what's in the main program here. So very very simple and straightforward. So let's bring now the command line in here, and. And so we see here there's the create bundstop coefficient .py. So that's a file which is generating our coefficients. Let's quickly again check that's the right thing is in there. So that's the one I've just shown before. So we've got 99 tabs. That's our cutoff frequency here, 45 and 55, and then we saving this here as this coefficient 12-bit.dat. So the only thing what I need to do is I just run this here in Python, so I don't need to start spider or something like this. And so if I now do the directory command here, so we see the file has shown up. And so remember this file is now read into our demo program here, so that shows up here. And so we see here, so we've got the 12-bit resolution or the scaling factor of 12-bit for the coefficients. And so what we just need to do now is just run this this program here. And so that's been hopefully compiled and is in the subdirectory x64, and I only compiled this as a debug here. So there's a fixed demo.exe in here, Okay, so now another program says written the filtered ECG to ecgfiltered.dat. So let's have a look here. So that's basically what I've written here after everything has run successfully here. So now we've got the ECG filtered here, and so now let's just plot this. And for this purpose here, I'm using gnuplot, and because Python is just too much overkill for this here. So let's first have a look at the ECG50Hz .dat. That's the one which is unfiltered, and move that into our window here. So that's the unfiltered ECG. So it looks quite terrible with all the noise inside. And so now let's plot our ECG. ECGfiltered.dat. Let's move that in, and we see here that this is now looking again beautifully clean and without any artifacts in here. And so the 50 hertz is gone. So we see that our calculations worked. So the only remaining components here, this is just muscle noise, but otherwise 50 hertz has been removed.